Ontario's public elementary schools are among the best in the world, thanks largely because of the commitment and efforts of educators. It is you, ETFO members, who consistently give your best, often under great challenges, and despite a government that continuously undervalues educators and chronically underfunds our education system. Despite the significant damage the Ford government has caused, I remain hopeful. I am hopeful because this year, our union persisted, we resisted, and we won. This year, we persisted through legal actions and stood strong in protecting your charter rights and your privacy at work. We resisted attacks and clawbacks with a 95% strike mandate. Our new central collective agreements will help to improve the lives of students and educators. In bargaining, we won funding for 401 new full-time permanent teaching positions, addressing rising violence in schools. We also fought for hundreds of teaching positions with a renewal of the Support for Students Fund and obtained a legal letter of agreement stating that in-person instruction is preferred. Once again, we secured your professional judgment. And through arbitration, we won a significant Bill 124 remedy and salary increases for 2022 to 2026. It is the highest increase in over a decade. Let these wins remind us that when we push back, the government cannot ignore us. With a potential Ontario election on the horizon, our work as educators, voters, and community members is to stand together and fight for a progressive and inclusive Ontario. This is now more important than ever, and we can make a difference. I hope you have a restful, well-deserved break, and I thank you for all you've done to improve Ontario schools.